بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we're gonna talk about non-Hodgkin lymphoma. It's a tumor cell that originated from lymphoid tissue. First of all, we're gonna talk about signs and symptoms. We have a swelling in the lymph node of the neck and armpit. Unexplained weight loss, that means the patient lost his weight without any exercise or any diet. Fever, night sweat, that means the patient sweat even in cold. Coughing, chest pain, fatigue, abdominal pain, and itching. For the pathogenesis, as we said, that the non-Hodgkin lymphoma are tumor cells that originated from lymphoid tissue, mainly of lymph node. Non-Hodgkin lymphoma represent in B cell, T cell, natural killer cell, and macrophage. It's caused by a lesion in proton coup gene or tumor suppressor gene, and that happens by either activation of proton coup gene or inactivation of tumor suppressor gene. Almost 85% of non-Hodgkin lymphoma are B cell lymphoma, and 15% of non-Hodgkin lymphoma are T cell and natural killer cell, and small percent are macrophage. For determine the aggressiveness of B cell lymphoma, we depend on the pattern of growth, that means where does the cell grow, and the second, the cell size. And for the pattern of growth, it either nodular pattern or diffuse pattern, and the second is more aggressive. The classification is classified into two classes, either B cell or T cell. The B cell are also divided into two classes, precursor B lymphoblastic lymphoma and the mature B cell neoplasm. The mature B cell neoplasm are divided into high grade, and that is diffuse large B cell lymphoma, and that represents from 30 to 58% of all non-Hodgkin lymphoma. And the second one is low grade, and that's follicular lymphoma, and that represents from 20 to 25% of all non-Hodgkin lymphoma. The second class is T cell. The T cell are also divided into precursor T lymphoblastic lymphoma and the mature T cell neoplasm. The mature T cell neoplasm are divided into high grade, and that is enteropathy type T lymphoma, and low grade mycosis fungoides. Laboratory diagnosis. We have here a CBC and two tests for a biopsy. For CBC, in the patient in early stage, it's still in the reference range, but when the disease progress, it show like anemia secondary to bone marrow infiltration, autoimmune hemolysis, bleeding, anemia of chronic disease, thrombocytopenia, leukopenia, or panacytopenia secondary to bone marrow infiltration, lymphocytosis with circulating malignant cell, thrombocytosis. Bone marrow aspiration and biopsy. We use this test for staging, not diagnosis. And we take bilateral biopsy because of the involvement of bone marrow is patchy, and it's seen in bone marrow section either in a focal, interstitial, or diffuse pattern. Biopsy of the extranodal site. It's approximately 30 to 35% of adult patients with non-Hodgkin lymphoma, the extranodal site are the primary site, and most common site is GIT tract. We use this test when we suspicion in hematolymphoid neoplasm. Differential diagnosis, Hodgkin disease, infectious mononucleosis. Treatment. First one is radiation therapy. We give the patient high dose of radiation for kill cancer cell and shrink the tumor. It is given alone or conjugated with another therapy. Side effects depend on the type and the dosage of the therapy, as well as the area undergoing radiation. Stem cell transplantation. We use this for two reasons. First is allows the patient to receive a large dose of chemotherapy and radiation therapy to kill the lymphoma cell that might not be killed with standard level of therapy. Second, use if lymphoma return after treatment. Biological drug. This medication used for enhance the immune system ability to fight cancer. What we do, we inject the patient with monoclonal antibodies intravenous and it will bind to cancer cell and duplicate the immune system ability to destroy the cancer cell. Rituximab, such a drug used for treatment of B cell lymphoma. Side effect, flu-like symptoms. Last one, radioimmunotherapy. This is a combination drug between radiation therapy and biological therapy. What we do, we inject the patient with monoclonal antibody with radioactive material to bind directly to cancer cell. And because of that, more radiation is delivered to cancer cell than normal tissue. Ibrutinib and tocilizumab, such a drug for treatment of lymphoma. Side effect is getting very tired and flu-like symptoms. Prognosis. The prognosis of non-Hodgkin lymphoma can be good, but is linked to the type of lymphoma, staging, and response to therapy. Approximately 66,000 patients were diagnosed with non-Hodgkin lymphoma in 2011, and about 18,000 patients died in 2011. These are our reference. My name is Mohammed Al Abdali, and this is my colleague who helped me. I thank you for listening to me, and I hope I get you good information.